Jesus, draw me ever nearer as I labor through the storm.
Well, I wish I had a short-term memory. Wish the only thing my eyes could see was the future burning bright right in front of me. But I can't stop looking back. Yeah, I wish I was a perfect picture of somebody who's never not good enough. Well, I try to measure up, but I mess it up. And I wish I wasn't like that. I wish I wasn't wishing anymore. Wish I could remember that nobody's keeping score. I'm tired of throwing pennies in a well. I gotta do something. Here goes nothing. Grace reminds me that my best days are not behind me. Wherever my yesterday may find me, well, I don't have to stay there now. See, my hourglass is upside down, and my Sunday soon is here and now. The clock is ticking, and I'm so sick and tired of missing out. I wish I wasn't wishing anymore. Wish I could remember that nobody's keeping score. I'm tired of throwing pennies in a well.
Ruth chapter 22, verse 14 says, "And when the hour came, he reclined at the table, and with the apostles, he said to them, I have earnestly desired to eat the Passover with you before I suffer. For I tell you, I will not eat it until it is fulfilled in the kingdom of God. And he took the cup, and when he had given the thanks, he said, Take this, and divide it among yourselves. For I tell you, that from now on I will not drink of the fruit of the vine until the kingdom of God comes. And he took the bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to them, saying, This is my body, for which it is given to you. Do this in remembrance of me. And likewise the cup after they had eaten, saying, This cup is poured out for you, the new covenant of my blood. The day of the Passover is kind of like the disciples' graduation day. Jesus was getting ready to be crucified, not just for them, but for everyone. Jesus was leaving them on their own, just like how our seniors will be leaving us and go on their own. They had no idea what was ahead of them. Jesus promised them as a graduation present that he would give them eternal life and the Holy Spirit. He made the promise for us too. During this time of communion, let us ask for forgiveness and remember his promises. Please pray with me. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for the seniors that will be leaving us soon. And Lord, put a hand on them as they go their separate ways. We thank you for the promise that you gave for us for eternal life. We thank you for sending your son to die on the cross for us. In your name I pray, amen.
I've noticed that every time I go there, I seem to be strayed off of the path to God. And when I go to camp, it helps me focus on what I really want to do and helps me get back on the right path to God. And that's just what I need right at the perfect time, and I get to spend it with everyone in the faith family here. My favorite verse is Philippians 4:13. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. That is my favorite, and I go to it for whenever I feel like I'm just down and I can't do anything and I just feel like I need help. So I know that He is there and He strengthens me and He helps me get through all the bad things and helps me get to where I need to be. And that's what my faith family is for, is to help me get through hard times. And I want to thank you.
So to have this strong of a faith family and then not that at home, it's been a real struggle. But that just drives me. That gives me more motivation to stick with it so that my family can go through the same thing. And I remember back a long time ago, before Rockford, before any of that, before I was even thinking about church, I was hanging out on the road by my house out in the country with my friends riding bikes and such, and Angie, young Angie here, she'd always stop and be like, hey, you should come to church. I'd be like, yeah. Then I never did. And then a year later, I'd see her again. She's like, hey, you want to come to church? And I never did. And then about eighth grade year, I finally was like, yeah. After the 100th of nagging, I finally was like, yeah, I'll do that. And I remember that first day of church. I was really scared. It was really awkward. I mean, seeing Anthony and seeing everyone, I kind of sat with the whole Leeds family because I knew them. But I distinctly remember seeing Sandy up here. I thought she was crazy. She was like going to town, worshiping, just loving it. And I thought she was just crazy. And then I got going and saying that, but it's okay. But you know, she now being one of my hugest role models, she's just like one piece of this family that could not be complete without everyone. Without her playing piano, without Sandy, Carlene and friends making food, it's just, it's awesome. And I love it so much. And with this family, I'm so happy to have you like do all the struggle times, like in high school and writing hard essays, and even to the point where my father passed away. It was so good to have a faith family. And I think back to the one verse, Joshua 1:9, it says, have I not commanded you, be strong and courageous, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. That's the backbone. And that's what really keeps me here, keeps me wanting more, and just it's family. And I love it. And being in this house and being here with everyone. You know, if it's me in church worshiping right there with the whole praise team and just singing praises, or if I'm just after school bored on YouTube, this is my home. And I love it. Thank you.
Thank you. now going to receive the gift of the Holy Spirit.
Choose and that it would just be a wonderful ride. Amen.